It takes any form of biomass, anything that has ever grown, and that gets inserted by this auger into this end of the machine. This is a motor that turns a screw inside that pulls the biomass up into this tube. As it goes through these different heat zones, these are heating bands, it depolymerizes. We turn the wood into its basic components, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, and carbon. We combine all the volatiles that are now turned into gases, because this is done under a high vacuum. We take those volatiles and we reconvert them and realign the molecules to create light gases, methane, CH4, then C2H6, you add another carbon, that's ethane. Add another carbon, propane. And we work our way up, adding carbon chains to go from methane to ethane to propane to 8 carbons is octane. Now we're turning into a liquid. Now we move up into biojet fuels. We move into biokerosenes, biogasoline. So as we're going, we're producing these fuels, gaseous and liquid fuels. The liquids are burned to displace fossil fuels. The gases, which are primarily hydrogen and methane, are burned in a generator to power the system, so it's totally self-sustaining. And the carbon comes out as what's known as biochar. And this process is called catalytic vacuum pyrolysis. This is the type of stuff we feed into the machine, agricultural waste. This is pelletized municipal solid waste, paper and plastic. This is sewage waste. We've run all of this stuff through the machines. And this is restaurant grease waste. That will go through. When we run wood and soy, when we run soybeans and wood through this machine, the reactor outputs a 55% liquid biocrudes, 20% solid biochar, and 25% gas. This is what the fuel looks like. This is 6,000 gallons of that biocrude oil. This is that liquid itself. This is one of the fuels. This stuff was pulled out of a block of solid carbon dioxide, dry ice. It's still liquid. All other biofuels begin to turn solid at 32 degrees Fahrenheit. We're 92 below zero here and heading south, and they're still liquid. So this is the quality of the fuel that we're producing. This is 12 tons of biochar. Solar power, you're going to have millions and millions of cubic feet of panels, waste panels, in about 30 years. You're going to have 443 million tons of waste turbine blades in 20 years. So you've got batteries that are being made. You've got toxins from batteries. Our process is a steel tube that'll last for a century and continue to produce the products that it produces. This is some of the products that we're producing. Virtro HM Biochar, that's available locally. BioBlast, that's another product. They're all made from pure, clean wood and all formerly a carbon from the atmosphere. This is what biochar does. It's kind of a long thing, but we won't dwell on it, but does lots of good stuff here. In fact, it does so many good things that people don't like to talk about all of the good things that it can do, but a few of them most important, it can revitalize depleted soils. It can recreate the natural web of life in soils, so you don't have to use nearly as much fertilizer. It'll clean polluted water. We're at the point where once this machine is built, wherever we drop it, when this license goes out on these machines, licensees are going to get a corporate entity, an LLC, that only has 90% of the stock available to the investors. The other 10% is held by the community through the council. They have no choice.